So the first thing I did was I took the cap to my water container and made a perfect half circle around it. And so when you look at a cylinder from the top down, that is the most circular that it will be. So any other angle that you look at a cylinder, the ellipse will be narrower. So knowing that, what I like to do when I start to draw a bottle or something like that is I imagine looking at the cylinder from the top and then squish that ellipse down so that the closer it is to my horizon line, the thinner the ellipse will be. So knowing that, I will purposely kind of exaggerate some of the ellipse shapes so that the bottom ellipse, the one that's closest to looking at it top down, will be the most circular, and I'll make that a little more circular than I think I need to, and then the one at the very top will be more squished down than I think I need to. And what that usually does is gives me more of a correct perspective on the ellipses. So what I would recommend is imagine a perfect circle toward the bottom of your cylinder, and as it gets higher up toward your horizon line, it gets narrower and narrower. One thing I like to do when I make a cylinder as well is if I have a ruler handy, I will make sure that each side of the circle is the same. To make a 3-inch cylinder, I gotta make sure that each edge is 1.5 inches from the middle, and I'll measure that out. you're interested in learning everything I know about painting in gouache, I have a course on ZenTeenAcademy.com called Gouache Painting Made Easy, and you can either follow the link in the description below or Google Gouache Painting Made Easy with Sergio Lopez.